warmly welcome our new secretary, Madam Lata Rao ji. She has just joined on the 1st of November, and we are thankful that this is the first occasion where we are welcoming her formally from the stage. A round of applause for her. I would like to, on behalf of the department for this conference, welcome Shri Som Mittal Sahib, Shri Srikant Sinha Sahib, CEO NASCOM. I would like to welcome Mr. Javed Abdi, Abhaji, large number of our friends from the sector. And then, of course, I would like to congratulate SPO India and Mr. Sahu and his entire team, and Mr. D.R. Sareen, CMD Elimco, for having organized this conference. This morning is a very welcome morning. We have vibrant Gujarat next door. So I thought, why should we not have something vibrant with our name too? And I think we should also have somewhere in our conference vibrant something. So it could be vibrant ability or vibrant inclusion. And I wish to assure this crowd, this entire gathering here, that the next time whenever we have a CSR conference, it would be called Vibrant Inclusion, and this would be the name for us. And I would, with this broad character, like to just state a few things from on behalf of my department. Elimco, as you all know, has undertaken this huge exercise of doing the very first step in disability, that is rehabilitation of persons with disabilities. You already know that we have been going around the entire country, and almost 4,500 camps have been organized to undertake the very step of providing a simple aids and assistive device to persons with disabilities. The idea is not just to give it at their doorstep. The idea is not just to call them and bring them on a particular stage. The idea is to change the mindsets of people in the entire country. I would like to tell you the programs that we have undertaken, particularly the programs where the Honorable Prime Minister has been present. We did a program in Varanasi, in his home constituency. Almost 10,000 plus persons with disabilities were there. The very idea of hosting a program like this ultimately was able to bring a lot of motivation, was able to bring a lot of consciousness amongst the general public, general people regarding persons with disabilities. The program that we did at Navsari, where the Honorable Prime Minister spent his birthday with us in Gujarat, there again we had more than 11,000 plus persons with disabilities. The entire state of Gujarat, I can say, in one day, with one stroke, we were able to change the way people thought about this entire sector, with the Honorable Prime Minister himself leading the charge. And further, we did 3 world records on that particular stage. It essentially made the difference. What we can say is that for persons with disabilities, rehabilitation and providing a simple aids and assistive device is the very first basic step which we need to undertake. Yesterday we were at Mizoram, and in Aizawl, the Honorable Chief Minister, the moment we did a huge program for him at his level, he himself was so motivated that he asked us to come back to the state of Mizoram, because accessibility is a major issue in some of these hill states, and he asked us to do an audit for accessibility in his entire state, and wanted us not just to concentrate on Aizawl but the 8 districts of Mizoram. So what I would like to say is that the proper ground for taking forth the schemes and program for disability has been undertaken. If any of the CSR initiatives of the corporates that are here, in the private sector, in the public sector, in whatever fashion they are, if they would like to partner with Elimco, I can assure you, if you go one step, Elimco would go 10 steps, and I'm sure we'll take this forward. On the issue of education, that is another big area where a lot of effort is required. We have 7 national institutes all over the country which are in various disabilities, where they have their sectoral responsibilities. They are spread all over the country, and we now have a new institution called the Indian Sign Language Research and Training Center. I would request any of our partners here to come forth and undertake a specified program in training and education for persons with disabilities, maybe in Delhi, maybe in Kolkata, maybe in Bhubaneswar, maybe in Hyderabad, maybe in Chennai, maybe in Mumbai, or any of the regional centers, and that again can be a major effort. I can tell you, REC, the regional, the rural electrification corporation, one of the then chairman, we are great friends. We undertook the modernization of the operation theater and the entire operation theater complex at Bhubaneswar, which where they do corrective surgeries for clubfoot and other such birth defects. And a large number of corrective surgeries now have been undertaken under the CSR initiative of REC, and that has gone a long way. The third area where it is most important for us to take on, where maybe NASCOM and maybe all our partners in the IT sector can take a call, we have a target of training at least 25 lakh, 2.5 million persons with disabilities till 2022. And for training such a large number, with IT as being the major initiative, we would request NASCOM and others to come forth with a plan where they can partner with us. The issue is not of funds, the issue is of partnering and providing the technical input and the very basis on which training can be provided to such persons with disabilities. I can assure you on behalf of our secretary that we would like to get a formal request from NASCOM to undertake training all over the country. We would like to fund it. We would also get CSR inputs. The Government of India and the Skill Training Department itself is very positive. As you have already seen, the Honorable Prime Minister himself had declared some of these issues. So we would like to take up a project for training, skill training of persons with disabilities. There's a lot of scope in this area. On BPOs and others, there's a lot of scope for blind people to undertake a large number of jobs. And I can assure you, some of these places where such persons are working, they at times work better than the other persons because they have a commitment to their job, they have a commitment to their getting the outputs. So this is taken forward. I would not say very much. I am very happy that SPO India has undertaken this here today. We had little time to actually prepare for this conference. I was away, and Mukesh Jain, my colleague, has since left the department. So we have a gap. But I assure you, with the secretary here and with all of our effort, with the effort of ELINCO, with the effort of all our organizations in the disability sector, you would not find us wanting. Agar aap ek kadam chalenge, hum log kehte hain, hum 10 kadam aage saath mein aapke chalne ke liye taiyar hain. Thank you. Jai Hind. Best of luck.